Cat Rocketship in the artist's studio.
She started out as a biology major, then switched to art, but somehow skeletons and bodies still seem to appear on her canvas. We're joined today in the studio with Cat Rocketship. First of all, I got to ask you about your name, Cat. Where did that come from?
I kind of chose it in college on a whim. It stuck, and I really liked it, so I've kind of kept it. I didn't really like my maiden name, so I went with Rocketship, and it's going to stick around, I think.
And Cat's short for?
Cat is short for Catherine.
Okay, but well, I think it's going to be very distinctive, very easy to remember. Tell us about your artwork.
Right now, I've been working on a series of paintings for about the last year on fear. Some of it is my fear, some of it is kind of global fears, some of it are fears that my friends have told me about. They've had nasty nightmares. This came about after an accident I had last year that laid me up pretty badly. I had a really nasty scooter accident.
Mm-hmm. Hit by a drunk driver.
Yeah, hit by a drunk driver. And from there, I kind of got a whole new view of fear, fears I never really thought I'd have. And I remember one of the thoughts in the whole healing process was, I guess I thought that I would grow out of fears like that. Mm-hmm. And so that's when I really wanted to start exploring this as a topic, because then I thought more about it, and I thought about what we do to hide our fears and kind of the secret fears we have and how it seems like a shameful thing, but really it's so very natural. It's mm-hmm. one of the most natural emotions. So I wanted to dive into that and think about what makes that fear run.
Now, you were wearing a helmet, so you were very lucky. Yeah. You realized how close you were?
Yeah, it was a very close call. I know if I hadn't been wearing a helmet, I would have died. And that was it was really sobering. And that was part of, I think, what fueled that fear was, you know, even though I was wearing a helmet, I was pretty banged up. I had a broken jaw. I had a concussion. I had internal bleeding. I had a really nasty broken leg. And then I didn't remember the accident. I don't remember much of the weeks after the accident, so it was a pretty jarring experience.
What medium do you like to paint with, and do you think this has been helpful in your healing process?
I like oils. I'm a huge oil painting nerd. I always have been. I'm kind of disparaging about the other mediums. And so all of these are in oil. There are a few in watercolor, I guess. And I really like the utilitarian mm-hmm. qualities of it, I guess. You can manipulate it really easily. Mm-hmm. As far as how it's helped with the whole process of getting over this, I think it's been very helpful. I think mm-hmm. there's been a notable change since I started writing down my feelings about fear. Some of the paintings are really personal. There's one that is a big, bruised, nasty, textural leg. And that one was really cathartic to work on. Some of them are of demons that are kind of representative, not of you know, internal demons, but of just fear embodied. And it was really fun to sit down and draw those and kind of put all my fear out on paper or in texture or in oil paint. And it was very cathartic overall.
What do you want people to look at when they look at your work? Kind of to think of their own fears?
Yeah, I do. And I actually was really pleased. We had a preview this last week, and it was a lot of fun because I'd walk around and people were talking about what they were afraid of, and I didn't expect that to happen, but I'd hear people say, I have this really crazy fear. And one of my friends told me, I fear two-headed dogs, like a head on both sides. And she was like, I know that sounds stupid. And I said, I'm afraid of Bigfoot. I don't believe in Bigfoot, and I'm terrified of it. So it was great to see that conversation spurred. I didn't expect that to happen.
Are you an artist full-time?
I am. I paint at least a little bit every day, and then I also organize events for other artists, figure drawing events every month, critique events every month, an event called Market Day that runs the last Saturday of the month, May through October, for artists and indie crafters to kind of work in with the farmers market crowd, too.
Wonderful. So. Do you think, looking down the future, you're going to get onto happier topics, maybe?
That's a good question. Even when I paint kind of happy things, they're kind of macabre. I think it comes from the biology backgrounds. Mm-hmm. I really am fascinated by bones and guts and organs and how that works and how it looks and how we can't see it all the time and how we don't even think about it. Mm-hmm. So even if it's happier in topic, it might still be a little macabre on the surface.
Well, we'll have to check back in with you and see how things develop.
I would like that.
All right, Kat, thank you very much for letting us come get a little sneak peek of your show.
Yeah, thank you, Molly.
And good luck, you bet. For KCCI, I'm Molly Cooney in the Artist Studio.
Kat's paintings, titled Demons and Worse Things, are on exhibit at the Memorial Union Gallery on the campus of Iowa State now through June 30th. You can also check out her website at katrocketship.com.